Welcome students to our Assam History lecture classes. Today we are discussing the medieval history part 9, and this will be the lecture 10, and this is the last lecture of the medieval history of Assam. So with this we end up the medieval history of Assam and we will begin with the modern history from our next class. So this Assam history is based on the new pattern of APSC for both prelims and mains, and also it is useful for the other state level government examinations. So as we have already studied that Assam history can be divided into 5 parts. So we have already covered the prehistoric and the ancient history. So right now we are covering the last lecture of medieval history of Assam, and under medieval history we have covered the first Mohammedan invasion of Kamrupa after the fall of the Pala dynasty. Then we have studied the Komota kingdom, Sutiya kingdom, Baro Bhuyas, Khan dynasty, Koch kingdom, Kosari kingdom, Joyantia kingdom, Ahom kingdom, and we have covered the Burmese war and the arrival of East India Company after the Treaty of Yandabo. So we have covered comprehensively the medieval history part. So today we will discuss the last part of the medieval history of Assam, is the important contributions and important personalities from the medieval history of Assam. So students, let us begin. First we will study the important personalities of medieval history of Assam. So first we are studying the Momai Tamuli Borborua. Now we know Momai Tamuli was an able administrator and the commander in chief of the army in the Ahom kingdom of Assam. He was the first Borborua, a new office created during the rule of Ahom king Pratap Singh. So these points are important, that the Borborua post was first created under the Ahom king Pratap Singh. He rose from a very humble position as a bondsman to the office of the Borborua. So he comes from a very humble background and he reached to the office of Borborua, which was a combined function of the chief executive officer and the Lord Chief Justice. And importantly, Momai Tamuli Borborua's sons Lasit Borfukon and Laluk Sula Borfukon played very significant roles in the history of Assam, and also his brother Baduli Fukon and daughter Pakhori Gabharu, an important Ahom queen. Also his granddaughter Ramoni Gabharu, daughter of Pakhori Gabharu and Ahom king Swargadeo Joyo Singh, was married to the Muhammad Azam Shah, son of Mughal Emperor Aurangzeb. So Momai Tamuli's granddaughter Ramoni Gabharu was married to the son of Mughal Emperor Aurangzeb, that is Muhammad Azam Shah. Now Momai Tamuli Borborua had important contribution to the administration of Assam in the medieval times. First of all, the pike system. We have thoroughly covered the pike system. So here it further mentions that the present economic life of rural Assam is mainly due to many measures inaugurated by Momai Tamuli under the pike system. In 1608, he organized the job functions of the Assamese officers and fixed quotas of pikes attached to each. The Bora, Saikia, Hazarika, Barua, Raskua and Fukan positions were created in line with the Mughal Mansabdar system, but they were adjusted to the customary gradation of officers prevalent in Assam from ancient times. So in the officer hierarchy in the pike system of Bora, Saikia, Hazarika, Barua, Raskua and Fukan positions were created in line with the Mughal Mansabdar system, but they were adapted to the customary gradation of officers which were prevalent in Assam from the ancient times. also contribution to the village economy, Mumai Tamuli was also entrusted with the task of reconstructing Assamese village life on a sound and secure economic footing. Spinning and weaving on part of women folk was made compulsory in every Assamese home, and it for this far-sighted policy of Mumai Tamuli that weaving has become universal among Assamese ladies, irrespective of caste, creed, or social status. So the amar Ahomet je ghor tatkhal thake, hei tatkhalor prosolon Mumai Tamuli protect ghorte korisile in every household. Aru hetu eta economic independence diaisile to the village level, to the villages. Every village was made a self-sufficient by providing with usual quota of artisans, priests, and other functionaries. Economic independence was also given, was also the goal of family life in Assam, every family producing its own necessities. So protect family and protect village nijor proyojonio kha samagri toyar korisil aru eta economic independence disile during the Ahom period. Now next, coming to the Lasit Borphukan, from 24 November 1622 to 25 April 1672. So Lasit Borphukan was a commander and a Borphukan in the Ahom kingdom, and he is known for his leadership in the 1671 Battle of Saraighat. So this is important, Battle of Saraighat 1671. We have already covered thoroughly the Battle of Saraighat in our last class. And Lasit Divas, this is important, that 24 November each year is celebrated as Lasit Divas or Lasit Day statewide in Assam to commemorate the heroism of Lasit Borphukan and the victory of the Assamese army at the Battle of Saraighat. Now next, coming to the next important personality, Laluk Sola Borphukan. Now he was a Borphukan of the Ahom kingdom who abandoned Guwahati after the Ahom win at Battle of Saraighat, and he aspired to be the king. So he was a brother of Lasit Borphukan, and he aspired to be king, and he abandoned Guwahati after the Ahom win at the Battle of Saraighat. However, he was assassinated in 1680 by a party of Phukans and Boruas. Now coming to the important women contributors during the medieval Assam history, we will cover Virangana Mula Gabharu, Ramoni Gabharu, Joymati Kuori, Purang Nayani, and Soti Khadini. So these are the important women contributors we are covering in today's class. The first we are covering is Mula Gabharu, also known as Nang Mula, was a Thai woman warrior of Thai Ahom kingdom. She fought against an invading army. The Ahom soldiers were encouraged to see Ahom women in the battle and conquered the enemy by conquering the victory of Thai Ahom. So Mula Gabharu was the daughter of Ahom King Supimpha and the wife of Phrasenmong Frungmung. King of the Ahom kingdom at this time was Suhungmung. Mula Gabharu's husband Phrasenmong heard that minister Khunlung and other warriors lost their lives in the hands of Turbak. So Turbak was a Mughal invader. So how Mula Gabharu played an important role in defeating Turbak, it's mentioned here. Her husband Phrasenmong promised by lighting 101 lamps, which is tradition known as Kinlao, that he will take the determination of protecting his country. After 7 days of fighting, the news of death of her husband came. In mourning, Mula Gabharu promised to destroy the murderers of his husband and the freedom fighters of the Ahom kingdom. On the fourth day of the war, she saw her husband's murderer, the commander Turbak Khan. Mula Gabharu strongly fights with Turbak Khan, but as Turbak Khan was a trained fighter, so Mula Gabharu was killed in the battle. But after her death, the Ahom soldiers were awakened in new strength under the leadership of Kangseng Borapatra Guhai. The Ahom soldiers defeated Turbak in the place called Mok. So such was the role of Mulla Gawaru in medieval Assam history. Now next we are covering Romani Gawaru. Romani Gawaru was a princess. Romani Gawaru was a princess of Kingdom of Assam and the first wife of titular Mughal Emperor Muhammad Azam Shah. So Romani Gawaru was the only daughter of Saofa Sutamla, who was a king of Ahom Kingdom, and his wife Pakhori Gawaru, the daughter of Mumai Tamoli Borborua. She was the niece of Lasit Borfukon and Lalok Sola Borfukon. She famously resisted Lalok Sola Borfukon's plan to hand over Guwahati to her husband. So the background is that Romani Gawaru was born as Ahom princess and was the only daughter of Swargadeo Joydas Singh. So Romani Gawaru was born as Ahom princess and was the only daughter of Swargadeo Joydas Singh, king of Ahom dynasty, and his wife Pakhori Gawaru, the Tamoli Kuori. Her real name was Romani Gawaru and was also known as Nangseng Gawaru and Maina Gawaru. Now she was the maternal granddaughter of Mumai Tamoli Borborua, who was an able administrator and the commander-in-chief of the army in Ahom Kingdom, the niece of Lasit Borfukon and Lalok Sola Borfukon, who are known for their participation in the Battle of Saraighat. Now when Mir Jumla invaded Joydas Kingdom and defeated him in the war, he made a truce with Mir Jumla on a condition for which his daughter Romani Gawaru had to be sent to the Mughal court, and she was given the Muslim name Rahmat Banu. And 5 years later, she was married to Aurangzeb's son Muhammad Azam Shah on Sunday, 13 May 1668 at Delhi. So such was the contribution and the prominence of Romani Gawaru in the Assam history. Then coming to the next important personality, Joymati Kuori. Now she was the wife of Thai Ahom Prince Godapani, later Supatpa. So she was accorded the honorific Mohiyokhi title on account of her heroic endurance of torture until the end, dying at the hands of royalists under Sulikfa or Loa Raja, because she didn't disclose her exiled husband's, Prince Godapani's whereabouts, thereby enabling her husband to rise in revolt and assume kingship. Joymati was born in the middle of 17th century in Madurai to Laithepena Borgohai and Sandra Daru. She was married to Langi Godapani Kuor, later an Ahom king Supatpa, who was established the Tunggungia king of Lines. Now, as we have already covered, under the instigation of Lalok Sola Borgohai, Loa Raja or King Sulikfa targeted the Ahom princess, and for that reason Godapani had to run away or has to take shelter in the Noga hills. And failing to find Godapani, Sulikfa's or Loa Raja's soldiers brought his wife Joymati to Zaranga Pathar, where despite torture the princess refused to reveal the whereabouts of her husband. However, after continuous physical torture over 14 days, Joymati died in 27 March 1680. Now, these points are important. The first Assamese language film, Joymati of 1935, was directed and produced by Jyoti Prasad Agarwala. Another film by her name was released by Manju Borua in 2006. Now, many important monuments and temples were built in her name. Their son, Lai, who took the name Rudra Singha or Sukhrungfa, built the Joysagar tank in 1697 in Sipsagar. Also built the Fakwa doll. Rudra Singha also built the Fakwa doll in 1703 or 1704, a pyramid-shaped temple constructed before the Rangnath or Shiva temple on the banks of Joysagar Tank. Also, we celebrate Joymati Day, Joymati Soti Joymati Divas. Commemoration Day of Joymati is held annually in Assam on 27 March. So these dates are important. 27 March is celebrated annually as Joymati Day. Now the next important personality was the Ahom Queen Kuranganayini. So the background is that in 1758, under the leadership of Mandora, the Burmese attacked Manipur. So at that time, the Jai Singha was the king of Manipur, who could not sustain Burmese attacks and he escaped to Assam. Jai Singha took shelter of Saupha Surempha, the Ahom king. Saupha Surempha helping Jai Singha led the battle of Lota Kota Ran. We have covered this in our last class. Lota Kota Ran in 1768 and got the throne back to Jai Singha in July 1773. Now, Jai Singha married of his daughter Kuranganayini to Saupha Surempha. Now, Swargadeo Surempha, according to the Ahom rituals, Soklong marriage procedure, married Kuranganayini. Now, Kuranganayini was the grand queen or chief queen of Saupha Surempha. In Assamese, grand queen is called Bor Kumari. After the death of Swargadeo Surempha, his brother Swargadeo Suniyapha became the king of Ahom kingdom. During his reign, the Mohamariya rebellion broke out. The rebels attacked Gorgaon and imprisoned Suniyapha in Joydol. Now, Raghav Moran, the chief rebel at Ramakanta, set Ramakanta in the throne and he himself became the Borborua. So, Ramakanta was made the king. However, due to Kuranganayini's intelligence and bravery, Swargadeo Suniyapha regained the throne. So, if any question comes in prelims exam or mains exam, students should be able to answer them correctly. Now, the next important contributor was the Sati Sajani. Now, she was the last queen of Chutia dynasty. She was the daughter of the Chutia king Dharmadhwaj Pal, also known as Dhir Narayan. Born in Sadia, she was married to Nityapal or Nitai, the last Chutia king. Now, in 1524, due to Nityapal's weak leadership, the Ahoms took advantage and attacked the kingdom at its weakest state and they killed Nityapal and thereby conquered Sadia. So, Sati Sajani, who played a prominent role in the fight against Ahoms, was asked to marry Sadia Khua Gohai, the Ahom governor of Sadia. Sajani preferred death to dishonor, and so she sacrificed her own life by jumping from the top of Chandragiri Hills near Sadia in 1524. So every year in Assam, April 21 is celebrated as Sati Sajani Divas to honor the sacrifices made by Chutia Queen. The government of Assam declares this day as state holiday. So this is important from our exam point of view. So with these students, we come to an end to the medieval history of Assam. I hope this lecture series was very helpful. We will begin the modern history of Assam very soon. Thank you for watching this. Thank you.